Mani, and today we're going to discuss about connectors in this video. So I wanted to share up a feedback of my students. They're not thorough with the connectors, and if you're not thorough with the connectors, it's going to be a real problem for you, especially for B1, because when you use connectors, so it gives a very good impact on your writing part, on your speaking part. So connectors, usage of connectors should be more and more in your day-to-day life in German language, or whenever you write down the writing part. It's very important to understand and learn the connectors, because the verb position changes. Connectors are of many types, right? If a word is not a connector, then also we can use them as a connector, but the verb position will not be changed. Fine. So that is the reason you have to mug up the connectors. And in this video, we have a lot of examples about the connectors. If you go through this video up till end, you're gonna find a lot of content into it. Apart from this, if you have any inquiry, any question related to German language, related to overseas education in Europe, you're most welcome to write down a comment, call us or contact us. And if you wanted to take up the classes, you can also take up the classes with us. We don't provide recorded sessions, we provide one-to-one sessions. And apart from this, you can just write down your comments if you feel that, you know, a lot of doubts, if you have any doubt related to German language. And if you're liking this video, please don't forget to subscribe our channel and like this video. Thank you.
Konjunktionen. So conjunctions in German, as you must have learned in English, you must probably already know that conjunctions are used to connect either two phrases or two sentences, or more than two phrases or sentences. So conjunctions in English are and, or, but, because, therefore, etc. We're gonna see more examples of these conjunctions, which are being divided into two parts in German. So they are subordinating conjunction and coordinating conjunction. So in subordinating conjunction, verb position is at the end, and coordinating conjunction, the verb position is on the second. So we have to learn that what are subordinating, what are sub-coordinating. Alright, so let's go for the subordinating conjunctions.
While,
because,
das,
that,
als,
as, or when,
when,
whenever, if,
ob,
whether,
wie,
as, how,
obwohl,
although. So the first two conjunctions are generally used in A1 and A2, which are while, das. The rest of the four conjunctions are being used A2 and B1, and the last conjunction is only being introduced in B1.
So now we come to coordinating conjunctions, which are und,
and,
aber,
but,
oder,
or,
then,
because,
sondern,
but. We will be having a lot of examples on the later of this video, so just understand what is what, and please remember to repeat after us.
So we move to the examples of subordinating conjunctions. The main thing that you have to remember is this: in while using subordinating conjunction in a sentence, the verb has to be at the end. So we have marked the verbs in red bold letters so that you can identify. So first conjunction is while.
Because.
Sie kann nicht tanzen, weil sie krank ist.
She can't dance because she is ill.
Ist glücklich, weil ein Geschenk bekommen hat.
He is happy because he has gotten a gift.
So as you can see, the verb ist, which is a conjugation of sein, is at the end. And in the second sentence, hat is at the end. So we move to the next example, das.
That.
Ich weiß, dass einkaufen im Internet billiger ist.
I know that shopping on internet is cheaper.
Sie hat gesagt, dass sie kommt.
She said that she is coming.
Now, als.
as or when.
So the conjunction als has two different meanings, as or when. We have given examples for both of them. Als ich 2 Jahre alt war, konnte ich laufen.
When I was 2 years old, I could not run.
Als ich in Mumbai war, hatte ich viel Spaß gemacht.
When I was in Mumbai, I had lot of fun.
Mein Bruder arbeitet als Lehrer.
My brother works as a teacher.
Now we move to the next example. When?
When, whenever, if.
Wenn ich Geld habe, gehe ich ins Kino.
When, if I have money, I will go to the cinema.
Wenn ich ein Auto kaufe, fahre ich nach Shimla.
When I buy a car, I will go to Shimla.
As you have seen, als means when, and the German word when also means when. The difference while using als and when is only one thing, that whenever we use als, we use it in past tense when we are talking about a single time event. For example, when I was 2 years old, when I was in Mumbai. But when we are talking about an event that is occurring multiple times, be it in past or present, we always use when. So the next connector is ob.
Whether.
Ich weiß nicht, ob der Lehrer heute kommt.
I don't know whether the teacher is coming today.
Wie.
As, how.
Läuft wie ein Gepard.
He runs like a cheetah.
Ich weiß nicht, wie wir das machen können.
I don't know how we can do that.
So the last conjunction is obwohl.
Although.
Obwohl ich Zeit habe, gehe ich nicht ins Kino.
Although I have time, I don't go to the cinema.
So now, before we move to the coordinating conjunctions, you must have observed here that obwohl, this connector, we have used this connector at the first position in a sentence. And whenever we are using a subordinating connector on the first position, the verb in that sentence goes to the end, but also the verb in the next sentence comes forward. Okay? So you can see gehe has come forward in the next one. So coordinating conjunctions und.
And.
Sie ist Lehrerin und hat 2 Kinder.
She is a teacher and has 2 children.
Ich habe einen Bruder und eine Schwester.
I have a brother and a sister.
So in coordinating conjunctions, you just observe that whenever we use a coordinating conjunction, the verb position remains same, which is at the second position. We just put the conjunction in between the sentences and we join them. So the second example is aber.
But.
Ich möchte Filme sehen, aber ich habe keine Zeit.
I would like to watch films, but I have no time.
Sie will ein Auto kaufen, aber sie hat kein Geld.
She wants to buy a car, but she has no money.
Oder.
Or.
Kommt heute oder morgen?
Is he coming today or tomorrow?
Möchtest du einen Apfel oder eine Banane?
Would you like to have an apple or a banana?
Okay. Next example is then.
Because.
Ich kann heute nicht kommen, denn ich habe einen Termin.
I can't come today because I have a meeting.
Now, you must have observed that the subordinating conjunction while also means because. And the coordinating conjunction then also means because. There is completely no difference at all in both the conjunctions. You can use them interchangeably. The only thing that you have to remember is when you are using the coordinating conjunction, the verb will be at the second position. And if you choose to use subordinating, then the verb has to go at the end. But they both mean exactly the same thing. Okay. The last example is sondern.
But. Rather.
Ich komme nicht heute, sondern morgen.
I'm not coming today, but rather tomorrow. So these are the only examples, and we feel if you're done with these examples, you know most of your connectors will be done, conjunctions, and it's very important, and please try to use them whenever you frame up the sentences, either in the Schreiben or in the Sprechen. This will be a very good impact on writing skills. Thank you.